been told we have a sort of a hard curfew here tonight, so that my stories have to be at least a little bit. So, getting right to business. This song came about in this way. I was doing a record called Belladonna in 1981. And I was being produced by a man named Jimmy Iovine, who you might have heard of also. And Jimmy came to me at the end of the 3 months and said, "We have made a beautiful album. It's terrific." He was also my boyfriend. "But you don't have a single." And I'm like, "Well, what? Okay, so what does that mean? Does that mean that I have to like go and take a week or two and try to write a single? I mean, I just wrote 12 songs, and what is a single exactly?" And he's like, "Well, whatever it is, you don't have it." And so this means, and I'm like, I'm arrogant. I'm like, "But that means one of my songs has to go." And he goes, "Yeah, it does. But think of it this way. If you don't have a single on your record that you have walked away from a big band to make, then you don't have a solo career." So I said, "Okay, so what is this song?" And he said, "Well, this happens to be your favorite artist in the world that you actually have already told me you would like to quit Fleetwood Mac and join Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, right?" Me, yes, I probably would. He said, "So Tom Petty, your new best friend, has offered to give you a song and sing it with you." So I said, "Okay." I went home, I thought about it for an hour, and thought like, "Okay, what am I, crazy?" And so anyway, this is the song that Tom gave to me that made Belladonna have a single, and probably the reason we're standing here tonight. Stop dragging my heart around.